I'd just like to thank Jim for the help in pushing this thing inside. Oh wait, Jim's not here. Yep, still there. You're still in front of the heater. Okay, now that we have the old transmission out, as you can see it here on the ground, we'll go ahead and get this new transmission installed here. So, should be pretty easy. This tranny change is a lot easier so far than I expected it to be.
Maybe that'll magically wipe it off.
No,
I didn't need the gases.
Sir, my dad wanted to know what you do all day. He's like, God damn, does he do anything at work?
Tell me I'm hanging out for a day.
He's like, man, every time, it was funny, because every time I'd go to like start tightening the bolt, he's like, damn. I'm like, hold on.
Okay, as you can see, the new transmission is installed right here. So now we just need to, you know, put the pan on and clean off some gasket residue. That's really hard to do like this. So, you know, what you want to do is go like this, make sure you're hitting the exhaust. Hit the exhaust so you can't do what you want to do. And so, yeah, I'll just keep doing that. And as you can see, everything's looking good here. So after finish this step of the tranny replacement, I'll be back and then we'll show you the last step of the tranny replacement in a little bit. You can see the pan. We're going to go ahead and use the original pan on this new transmission and just put a new gasket on it. Are we clear? You have gotten awfully dirty. What have you been doing?
Just getting a camera shot, sir, and it's only up
there. Ah, that hurts my head. Alright, well, you're putting the pan on. I'll go ahead and start dumping the fluid in.
It's just a little wet. It's all it does to me.
5 quarts, right? I'll go ahead and start putting that in while you're putting that on. Yay! Right. Oh, here.
Put the oil in it.
Yeah, put the oil in it. Let's hold it up.
See, that's gonna work.
How many geniuses does it take to install a transmission pan?
Apparently not.
Just one to hold the camera?
Right.
Well, that's so nice of you to say I'm a genius.
Right. Well, on this slide. I'll get started on the cable bolt. You'll have the rest of them done by the time you get one in.
What?
You want to say that again?
I said, now how big of tires did you say you wanted to put on this thing? Oh, a target top. That's right, I just said target.
Practice a chop.
Well, are you sure you can't do T-tops?
Yeah.
This is phase two of the transmission repair swap.
Trip
battery.
I cut through the floor.
Don't do that.
Oh, really? Blazer's not tall enough.
It's not tall enough?
Well, maybe if I go from that side. The torsion bar is kind of...
I'll cut it too.
Well, now I need extension
cord. No. Sorry you called it. Matt doesn't like to listen to people.
What are these extra parts?
Extra parts?
Extra parts.
Do you always end up with extra parts?
Well, you want to make sure you have extra parts. That way, you have extras.
Anybody gonna put the transmission fluid in?
Yeah, first we have to finish the tranny repair. I mean replacement. Where am I gonna cut this side at? I guess I only have to cut the front for right now, huh? Gonna bend it down a little bit?
Yeah. Hey, Jim's coughing, you're coughing. Button was a little slow. What's that again, sir?
Said we got the other half of the fanning out.
Hot?
Yeah, it's a little hot. Even the exhaust is just blowing on it.
Yeah.
Not through it.
Well, you did do a hot lap around the block.
I did. I can't believe we don't have any pipe.
What do you mean you can't believe it?
Sir, can't believe it.
Sir, you try to get rid of everything.
No.
Yes.
But,
you could probably use part of that body stand that you don't like. It's a little small, but it's a tube.
Go cut the neighbor's fence down.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, they'll never know because they built a fence over the other side of it. You're just gonna sit here and stare at this thing?
Yeah.
Is that a hole in it? Sir?
Where?
There? Or is that just discoloration?
That looks like some oil.
I don't like the cuts that you did, sir. They're not very straight.
That's Jim's.
Jim? Cuts aren't very straight.
I couldn't. I had no choice.
I'm disappointed.
That is the easy one.
Cross member was in my way. I had to bend the blade to get to it.
Are you supposed to be able to see through these?
Usually when, like I said, when I've had pulled them out, they've been all busted up, that honeycomb.
But you can't see nothing. It's really hot in there still, though.
just need a big drill. We drill right down through it. Well, guess we won't know till we get a piece of pipe. Because I don't want to drive anywhere like that far. It's not like a good sounding loud. It's like a crap sounding loud. Like the kind of attention you don't want.
They're almost like a lot of the Toyotas.
Yeah. Big piece of
like
junk.
The old Toyotas. Or something. I mean, really, you could just go ahead and, put this.
Can we cut that in pieces and straighten it out? It won't be long enough.
Just get some Mountain Dew cans and glue them together.
Yeah.
Just haul them out on the top and the bottom and then glue them together.
That's right.
Sauce pipe.
There you go. Tom, what, sir?
Well, something. I was wondering, did we put any of that in the back of the old beast?
Of course we did. I don't know what we did to all the extra stuff we had left from Angel's truck.
That's what I'm talking about. Did we throw it in the back of the old beast?
Well, we threw it somewhere.
Of course you did.
Didn't you take a load to work?
Not that stuff. The only thing I took to work was the
hood. No, when we took my truck, remember? We took a bunch of stuff.
Yeah.
Because we hooked the hood. Remember we threw all that stuff on the hood and threw it in the back? I think that's what we did.
Let's just go cut a piece of exhaust off the old beast.
Well, you gotta use that thing for something. We got a piece of exhaust in Angel's car, probably. I got some headers upstairs we can cut up. I don't think there's a piece that straight, though.
Oh well, I guess we're screwed.
Till tomorrow.
I don't want to work on this tomorrow. Why can't parts stores be open all night long?
Isn't the one
that is on
277?
That's the only one.
Yeah, the one in Kent. It's open till 11. We could take this thing.
Walmart have?
Huh?
Yes, that's it. This concludes our fun times. Safety first.
Safety first.
This bike is really working out. Sweet for this.
Thank you.
safety glasses. As you can tell by the metal in my eyeball. Business line over that. Slide right over it, as you can see.
Well, if you cut the flared end on it, wouldn't it slide in there? Are we gonna have enough length if we do that, though?
Yeah.
Okay. You only need 15 inches, right?
We got 2 inches to spare. Nobody? Okay. We need new safety glasses deal a couple of weeks ago. Never got any, huh?
You're gonna put safety glasses over your glasses?
No. But swap them out. And then.
Oh, right. Gotcha.
Let me see the hood.
What do you want?
Nothing.
Yeah, the peep. It's not Easter yet. No peeps.
It's raining over here. Then you go over here. And it is not raining. It's the weirdest. It's weird. Lucky for us, we're not getting rained on. Talking to you.
Oh, okay. I'll be over here standing around.
And I'm just gonna take more of the small pieces out, see if I can maybe get the rest of this headliner out, since it needs to go. And that needs to go too. So stuff like that. And you want to put all your bolts, screws, in the same spot. And I'm going to try to label everything so that way when putting it back together, actually know where it goes. Which is pretty helpful. Yep. Magnetic screwdrivers are very nice because I dropped this one and caught it. Sweet.
Can't believe you went and got it replaced. Whoops! Didn't see you there. Oh yeah, here, just get a shot of the final part of the tranny repair replacement. I don't know if it's showing up. I don't even know what I'm looking at under here, but here you go. The last part of the tranny repair. And now we'll go see if it worked.
Seems like it has more power. You ready to take this thing to the drag strip?
Yep. Watch how fast it changes lanes.
Quick update, since we didn't make an update on the way home. No. The new transmission is working perfectly, and so yeah, I'd like to thank Rob Razd
for
Meta
for coming through once again.
Coming through once again, he's the man. Oh man, don't scratch the paint, sir. Just came up here for a good shot of my new shoes. Man, is all the light you have in this place? See, still got some protective tape. How are you gonna get that off now that the fender's on?
It doesn't touch.
Oh. Figure what we're gonna do for little rubber flappers in there. Inner fender things. You're just gonna leave it how it is.
No, I'll probably make a little flap to keep it from falling up there.
Hey. handprints? Come on. What is this? Oh, I didn't know you had these pieces done. Yeah, we need to get bolts for this.
Yeah.
It's only two bolts. Yeah. And the bottom one, you're going to have to do the underneath ones too, because you can see the first one. Man, imagine this thing with a fleet side bed on it. This would be like probably the coolest truck ever. It would still be cool, but it could be the coolest truck ever.
Flat bed on.
Why so sad? I was confused. Sir, you don't have the felt piece on this door. Oh, we got problems?
Yeah.
Jeff warned you about these problems, sir.
A little mark right there?
What about it?
Oh, then I forgot to fix that. That's an issue. And I slipped this piece up.
Oh, you scratched it. Oh, you chipped it. Look at Jim chipped it. Right here.
This one.
Look at that. Can you believe that? I told him to be careful.
I was careful.
Yeah, I see that. What do you want me to do? Take the door apart and repaint it? You want to touch it up?
Yeah, well, I didn't know if we had to. We could put something on it.
Yeah, you got to put something on it.
Oh, okay.
It's going to rust.
Well, that's what I was
saying. Did it chip down to metal?
I don't know. I can't tell.
I can't tell either.
So.
You're going to need a magnifying glass so we can see. No. We'll just touch it up.
It's just that when I slid that in.
Yeah, we'll be more careful, would you? And let's get rid of all this tape that you don't need up here.
Without a mark.
I know. How can you put the whole front end on without chipping anything, but you slide a little mirror thing on, and next thing you know, we're repainting everything.
That one stupid little bar sliding up.
Hey, you got to get bolts for this, too?
Well, I have these ones. I was just going to use.
Oh, okay.
But I got to...
And the course board came out much better this time.
I got to do some work.
What?
Well, I got the front end perfectly square.
Yeah, well, that's the first problem, because it probably wasn't.
And then, I was looking at... It's funny, because all the bolts went in, everywhere.
Yeah, well, that's not how it came apart.
Right. But this side, like right here, where the headlight thing is, it's got clearance. That side's tight. So I moved it over that way, just the front end. And left the core support. I was wondering if I should just try to move the core support over a little bit.
The core support? I mean, we have no idea where it used to be, right?
Well, I put it back
where it was. Oh, you put it back where it was?
Yeah, because I clamped on the angle iron right there and then.
Oh, right.
So it should be in the same.
Yeah, I mean, I doubt this front end was square. We just moved it around to make the hood fit.
The hood fit, right. But.
Which means you're going to have to step.
Right, that's what I figured too. That's why I was just getting like all this stuff as close as possible, and then I kind of figured, well, I'll just check and see. Like, I got it like perfectly square, but I figured that too. It was like, that's what I told my dad. I was like, I don't know why I'm wasting my time doing this. We'll get the hood, and then
this
will be right anyway.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. Sure, you're gonna. I know you're definitely probably gonna have to move it one way or the other when the hood goes on.
I'm definitely gonna have to move the core support that way for it
come this way with it as well. Because it's already, like I said, it's close to touching.
Mm-hmm. Yep, it's dark in here, I know.
Yeah, so shim that one bottom one out a little bit more. Tan just looks good.
Right. Other than that, it looks like it fits pretty good. Half a shim here. Interior's coming along nicely. Mm-hmm. Nice and clean. Couldn't see your valve cover bolts. I'll take a look at them now and let you know what I think. Yep, it's pretty sweet.
Run, boy. No problem. Quick start. If I'd have known the camera was in there, you'd have got the whole thing. Now that's a truck right there.
Woo!
Matt's favorite truck. See, we keep it real clean. Got all those leaves in here.